Oh, we can find it to be praised. Hallelujah! There is nothing he cannot do. Come and see the Lord. Yeah. I shall not fear the battle, if thou art by my side, no wonder from the pathway, if thou will be my guide. 1, 2, 3, let's go.
The King of creation. Oh, my soul, praise him, for he is thy health and salvation. All ye who hear, now for his temple draw near, joining in glad adoration. 1, 2, go.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation.
Especially be in the name of Jesus. I just want us to know, to understand Jesus Christ. Amen. Jesus, He is the King that the royal family don't understand. Jesus, He is the bread of life that the baker can understand. Jesus is good teacher that the educator can understand. Jesus is righteous that the judges can understand. Jesus is Alpha and Omega that the scientists don't understand. Jesus is the truth that the politicians don't understand. Jesus is the light of the world that the electrician can't understand. Jesus is great physician that the nurses, doctors, physiotherapists don't understand. Jesus is wisdom that the philosophy can't understand. Jesus is the traffic warden Jesus is the traffic that the traffic world don't understand. Jesus is the restoration that the funeral director don't understand. Jesus is the head of the treasure that the banker can't understand. Jesus is the lily of the valley that the prophet can't understand. Jesus is cornerstone that the architect can't understand. Jesus is the life that the biologist can't understand. Jesus is the rock of ages that the theologist can't understand. Jesus is the good shepherd that the farmer can't understand. Jesus is all in God that the old animals can't understand. Jesus, he is the truth that the lawyer and the judge can't understand. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord, brother. Let's give the Lord a clap of it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We shall continue service by taking our first reading this morning. The first Bible reading this morning is taken from the book of James, chapter 1, from verse 1 to the end. If you are here, shout hallelujah! I will read verse 1, and you read verse 2. We continue doing that, and we read the last verse all together. I read, James, a poor servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad. Verse 2. Verse 3. Knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. 4. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask God, who gives to all liberally, and without reproach, and it will be given to him. 6. For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. Verse 8. Let the lowly brother glory in his exaltation. 10. For no sooner has the sun risen with a burning heat than it withers the grass. Its flower falls and its beautiful appearance perishes. So the rich man also will fade away in his pursuit. Verse 12. Let no one say when he is tempted, I am tempted by God. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he himself tempt anyone. Verse 14. Then when desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And sin, when it is full grown, brings forth death. Verse 16. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning. Verse 18. So then, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath. Verse 20. Therefore, lay aside all filthiness and overflow wickedness, and receive with meekness the implanted word, which is able to save your souls. 22. For if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like a man observing his natural face in a mirror. 24. For he who looks into the perfect law of liberty and continues in it, and is not a forgetful hearer but a doer of the word, This one will be blessed to what he does. 26. Good to everybody. Want to go? Pure and undefiled religion before God and the Father is this: to visit orphans and widows in their trouble, and to keep oneself unspotted from the world. May God bless His word in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Hallelujah, church. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the King of Glory. Hallelujah. Praise the Ancient of Days. The I Am That I Am. The author and the finisher of your faith. The reason why you are here today. If you are happy to be in the presence of God this morning, shout a big hallelujah. A big hallelujah. A big hallelujah. A big hallelujah. If you know your God is a great God, shout hallelujah. If you know your God is a consuming fire, shout hallelujah. If you know your God is mighty and mighty, shout hallelujah. If you know your God is a great man, shout hallelujah. We are praising God from the beginning to the end today. If we have mouth all over our bodies to praise God for all the good things, it will not be enough. What do you think, church? Praise the Lord. Are we tired? Are we tired? Let's be on our knees, on our feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we ready? You have praised my God unquenchable. Always perfect in my way. For your glory is incomparable. Who can dwell from your mouth? Who are great? Who are great? Always perfect in all your ways. For your glory is incomparable. Who can dwell from your mouth? Who are great? Who are great?
You are, oh, you are, you are. I was like, who is cool here? That this is wonderful. So they were doing, when it's the turn of Rogo, I said, this is my language. I was so happy, jumping, it wasn't as if that was my first time. I just stood up and I jumped to the front. So as soon as singing with them, they were like, be the first time, you know, and they all gathered together with me and they showed me love. They didn't even do as if it was my first time. And I want to thank God that here I am today standing among the choristers. I want to give glory to Almighty God. Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah. If you are happy to be in God's presence this morning, on your feet, shout hallelujah. You are sitting down, on your feet, shout hallelujah. Brother, our God is good. He has been so wonderful to us. It's the reason why we are alive today. Shout hallelujah. Amen. I welcome everybody to this great occasion this morning. And I pray that as you have come to the presence of God, the Lord will bless you mightily in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I want you to turn to your neighbor and say, you are welcome. Say, you are welcome. Amen. The Lord meet us at every point this morning in the name of Jesus. As you have come to rejoice in His presence. A thing of joy will not cease from our family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. I'm honored this morning to introduce and to welcome to us the guest speaker for this great occasion this morning. Join me as I welcome Sister Jessica. A round of applause.
Never come, but I thank God that it's here now. Amen.
Yes.
The privilege is mine. And I want to thank the pastor especially for inviting my husband and I today. As the MC said, my name is Sister Jessica Jombrana. And I'm here with my wonderful husband, John Webster's Brian. The Lord has committed a special, a very special and unique ministry to our hands. We have been members of MFM for almost 12 years now, from Nigeria to this place, and our home branch is MFM Dagenham, where Pastor Manke is. So I bring you greetings from MFM Dagenham. Praise the Lord. The Lord has committed the ministry and a Trinidad mission into our hands. Our primary objective is to mainstream premarital sexual abstinence and mutual fidelity in marriage. We teach young adults how to negotiate their sex life, not just from a position of strength, but holiness. When we're talking about holiness, we're talking in respect for the fact that the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 16 to 20, every sin a man commits is outside the body. But the sin of sexual immorality is a sin against your own body. It says that our body is the temple of the living God. We have been bought with a price, which is the precious blood of Jesus Christ. So the Bible admonishes us to honor God, glorify God with our body. Amen? Amen. God no longer dwells in temples made with hands. That's how we can gather anywhere to praise and worship Him. He says He dwells in us. Our body is His temple. So we must not defile this body as the temple of the living God. So when we talk about negotiating your sex life from a position of holiness, we're talking about the fact that the Bible says in Genesis chapter 2 from verse 24 to 25, it says, for this purpose, a man shall leave father and mother and be joined clearly unto his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Verse 25 is so interesting. It says, the man and his wife were naked and unashamed. Not the man and a girlfriend, not the man and a mistress, not the man and a fiancé, not the man and a cousin, not the man and a husband, man and his wife, not the man and wives. They were naked and unashamed. When a man is naked with somebody he is not legally married to, whatever comes out of that is shame. And that's when we start talking about abortion, cover-ups, what do we do? We start fretting and then there's shame. When a woman that is not married gets pregnant, is not yet married, of course you know what happens. You all live in the society. But when a woman that is happy to marry gets pregnant, there's joy. There's celebration. Amen? Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Our ministry is family friendly. We make the family to understand that God hates divorce. Because in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 16, it says that he that joins himself to a harlot becomes one with a harlot. The Bible is talking about the oneness that comes out of a sexual covenant, because sex is a covenant relationship and it's a blood covenant. With that oneness that comes, the Bible says when the two have become one, once there's a breakup, once there's a tearing apart, you're tearing something into two. There are wounds on both sides. God does not condemn us when He says, I hate divorce. I hate what divorce does to homes. I hate what divorce does to the man. I hate what divorce does to the woman. So at the end of the day, our own is to recognize that that's not God's will for us. The Lord has given us a strong voice against all these social malaise, and especially against all forms of sexual immorality. When we're talking about sexual immorality, we're not just talking about fornication and adultery, no. We're talking about masturbation. We're talking about homosexuality. Yes, we're talking about pornography that is mainstreaming all sorts of sexual perversion in the society today. That's what we're talking about. We're talking about sexual immorality. Amen. Praise the Lord. So that's why we network with churches to talk about the consequences of all these things. Because I haven't really got much time on my hands. What I basically do is to summarize our teachings. When we have the opportunity to come again, then we can now talk about in details. Incidentally, I just want to appeal to you before I start the message, because I was just introducing what we do. Before I start a summary of my message for today, because I'm going to summarize our message, I want you to understand that our teachings have a lot of adult content in it. It might make you a bit squeamish. It might make you feel uncomfortable, but just tell yourself you're in a Christian biology class today. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I thought I should just let us know that. But you wonder, why is it that our teachings have a lot of adult content? You see, there's a research done by BBC, and that research focused on young people, teenagers, our children. And they asked them, they teach the students about, what do you call it now? Sex education, yeah? Yes. So they did a research and asked them, how do you see the sex education teachings in your school? Because, you know, they always want to do research to improve on what they're doing. So the students that answered, one of them said, they only teach us how to help a man use a condom. That's all they teach us. How to help a man use a condom. And when we ask them, what about love? What about affection? And they say, no, don't worry about that. That is for when you get married. But the love and affection should come first before you learn about how to help a man use a condom. The marriage should come first before you learn how to help a man use a condom. Because even with the use of the condom does not protect you from the oneness that comes from a sexual covenant. It does not protect you from the soul tie covenant, because it's a soul tie covenant. Your heart is glued to that person, because sex is more spiritual than physical. When we went on schools outreach, we started with the schools, then we went on television, then we went on radio, and one of the things we learned when we went to the schools outreach is that the children really know more than we thought they knew. You know, because one of our teachings, one of the students got up and said, and you are telling us not to think one another, but what about oral sex? And I said, who taught you about oral sex? It's dangerous, it's unhygienic. What taught you about that? I said, oh well, angels come to the school, and that's what they teach us. They teach us about oral sex. And I'm like, so these children already know more than we know. They know more than their parents know. The church cannot keep playing the ostrich anymore. Because now the Bible says that at the end time, knowledge will increase. We are at the end time. That's why economies that are selling oil are no longer the buoyant economies. The economies that are buoyant now are knowledge-based economies. Facebook, oh, they're making $1 billion. Google, Microsoft, because they are knowledge-based. So it's important for us to get the knowledge, so that when our children ask the questions, we give them the right information. Amen? The Bible said, my own people perish for lack of knowledge. A 9-year-old girl was very ill. She was so sick, and her parents were wondering, what's wrong with this child? What's wrong with this child? Eventually, the doctors did all sorts of tests on her. They couldn't find out what was wrong with her. At the end of the day, they went further. It wasn't malaria, it wasn't typhoid, it wasn't pneumonia. What is it? They found out that this girl was suffering from what they call a systematic forceful penetration. And they said, what happened to her? She was so weak to talk. By the end of the day, she was able to talk. And she said, each time she goes to school, her schoolmate takes her and rapes her. A 14-year-old boy, who is the school proprietor's son, will take her in and rape her. And for many years, this was going on, and the parents didn't know. So it had damaged her reproductive organs, and she died. So when she died, they called that boy, they arrested the boy. The boy said that it's because every day he goes to higher things, and he's always watching pornography. And that when he finishes watching the pornography pushes him to do something, to sleep with somebody. And that's how he ended up being addicted to sex and abusing that girl. But you ask yourself, where were the parents of that girl? The atmosphere was not conducive for this girl to confide in her mother or her father. Because he said, the boy told her, if you tell anybody, I'll kill you. So that fear was in her. So you can imagine how this girl would feel 9 a.m. every morning. 8 a.m. every day, taking her to school Monday to Friday. You can imagine the terror that goes on in her heart. So that's how we tell parents, you have to create the atmosphere to enable your children to talk to you. To enable your children to hear you. It's not your pattern of, oh, if I hear film, I'll kill you. No. You don't even know what film is, and she doesn't know what film is. You know, so we have to create that atmosphere for us to be able to relate to one another. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let me quickly go to my message. Genesis 38. Can somebody read Genesis like it? Because my Bible can't stay here and do places in this church. Genesis like it. I'm speaking about consequences of sexual sin. It's just a summary of a message. Genesis 30, can somebody put you in? Praise the Lord.
And it came to pass.
It came to pass.
At that time. That Judah.
Went down.
From his brethren. And turned into a sexy Adullamite.
He went to be with an Adullamite. Okay?
His name was Hira.
His name was Hira.
And Judah saw a daughter of a certain Canaanite.
Praise the Lord. Hang on. Genesis 38 is a chapter I would encourage all of us to read. Please, if you get home, make sure you read it. But let me summarize it because of our time. Just as he said, Judah went down with an Adullamite. The chapter before it was when his brethren conspired to sell Joseph, their brother. Judah is one of the 12 sons of Jacob. You remember how they conspired and sold their brother out of envy. They have not finished selling his brother. He was the one that said, let's not kill him. Because the brothers wanted to kill Joseph out of envy. He said, no, he's our own blood. He said, what will we pay to kill him? So let's sell him. They sold him into slavery. He left his brothers. Apparently, he was disgusted about what happened. He went to a friend of his. The man is from Adullam. So they say he's an Adullamite. He followed him to his own town, a Canaan. And when he got to Canaan, he met the daughter of a man called Shua and married the daughter of Shua. The daughter of Shua gave him three sons, Er, Onan, and Shelah. When Er grew up, he married a wife, found a wife for Er, his first son. The wife's name is Tamar. Tamar married Er. Er died. The Bible says that God killed Er because of his wickedness. He died. After he died, the father said, you, Onan, you're the next. Please fulfill a duty to your brother. At that time, there was a law in Israel that if a man dies, the next brother would marry the wife, but the children would not be the children of the man that is alive. They would be the children of the man that is dead. Yes, that was the law then. Onan didn't like that. So, when the Bible said when he meets with his brothers and gets brother's wife, he will spill his seed. He wouldn't want to impregnate her. Because of that, God killed him. So, those are two men dead because of one woman. Then Judah got wise and said, no, he got a friend and said, my two sons have died because of this woman. There must be something wrong with this woman. He just lied to her. He said, go back to your parents' house. When my third son grows up, I will allow him to marry you. The woman agreed. She went home. After some time, she realized that the third son had grown and he wasn't given to her as husband. So she got angry. But the Judah was afraid that the son might die since two sons had already died. So she decided, she was angry, and she, in the space of time, Judah's wife died, and Judah mourned his wife. After mourning his wife, he decided to go to where his workers were keeping his sheep. They were taking care of his sheep. Somebody told Tamar, your father-in-law is going to so-and-so place, Timnah. He's going to see the people who are taking care of his sheep. She decided to play the harlot. She removed her widow's clothes. She wore a veil. She dressed up very well, went to the streets, and you know men, looking for women when they shouldn't look for women, on the streets. That was when he picked up this so-called prostitute. He didn't know it was his daughter-in-law. He went and slept with her just one time. Just once. That's why I believe these young girls, when they listen to my radio program and they call me, and they say, sister, please, help me, pastor, help me. My boyfriend told me he loved me so much, and that the only way to prove the love is to sleep with him. Now I slept with him only once. And I'm pregnant. Only once, so it was only once, pastor. Please pray for me. I committed abortion. He said I was aborted. I aborted 2 weeks ago and I'm still bleeding. Please, pastor, pray that I don't die. Please. So I believe them. When they made this call to tell me it was only once. But once is more than enough for the damage to be done. Yes. Tamar got pregnant. When she got pregnant, you know there's a law that a woman that commits adultery must be stoned to death. So they brought her out and said they must stone her to death. But guess what happens? When this man wanted to sleep with Tamar, when he thought she was a prostitute, she said, if you sleep with me, what will you give me? Prostitutes sell their body to make money. So he said, what will you give me? He said, I will have goats. I will give you one of my goats. He said, where is the goat? He said, the goat is not here. I will bring it. Ah, how can you bring it after sleeping with me? That's not one line now. No way. He said, I will bring it. He said, no. He said, give me a pledge to show that you bring it. The man said, I don't have anything here. What can I give you? She said, I'll suggest something. Give me your ring. Signature ring for that a king, only a king wears the signature ring. Give me your bracelets. Only a king wears that bracelet, the symbol of authority. And give me your staff of office, your symbol of power. Do you know the man agreed and gave them to the prostitute, so-called prostitute. So when they brought her out and said they must stone her to death, they went and told the king, Judah is the king. He was the king that reported the evil to him. Judah comes from a lineage of kingship. In the Bible says, the scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor the lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh comes. For unto him shall the gathering of his people be. That's the Bible prophesied about the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is the Shiloh that will come through the lineage of Judah. So you see the kind of kingship Judah has, the power, the authority that Judah had, but Judah gave it away on the altar of sex. That's what we do when we commit sexual sin. We give away our authority, our power to bind and loose. Why is there no more power in the church? Why? Pastors are fornicating with choir members. A man listened to my radio program yesterday say, I'm the leader of the choir in my church, but I'm neck deep in homosexuality and sex. Leader of the choir, he will come and sing. That guy is a worshiper. I love him when he handles the mic. But committing anal sex. He said, please, Pastor, help me. I just listened to your program. Help me. I'm very deep in homosexuality. So this man handed over his authority to power to bind and loose. God would say, Jesus came and said, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions, over every power of the enemy. Nothing shall by any means harm you. Why are we not treading upon serpents and scorpions? Because of the sexual pollution in the body of Christ. So when they told them they must stone her to death, she said, before you stone me, let me say the truth. Go and tell the king that the person who impregnated me is the owner of this ring, the owner of this bracelet, and the owner of this staff. By the time they told the king, he couldn't enforce the law anymore. He couldn't. He became powerless. A whole Judah. The Bible refers to Jesus as the lion of the tribe of Judah because he came from the lineage of Judah, the lineage of everlasting kingship. But he gave it away on the part of sex. The woman, he couldn't do anything to the woman. He said, please, she has been more righteous than I. Leave her. I'm the one that is guilty. Praise the Lord. So that disgrace came upon Judah just that moment. That's what happens when we commit sexual sin. Pornography is the end time strategy of the devil to finish the church, everybody. That's why you hear people who say they are born again addicted to masturbation. Because pornography has told them that masturbation is okay. As they are watching the pornography, they are committing the masturbation. I know because a lot of people call me and tell me. They test me and tell me, please, mother, help me. What they're listening to my radio show, say, please, you're talking about me. A young man said when he was small, his parents loved him so much, they kept a TV in his room. At that time, there was no mobile phone. If you want to watch pornography, it's happened 9 p.m. in London here. You just turn on your TV, you see women having sex with women, men having sex with men. So he said that's what he was watching because his parents left a TV in his room. One day he became very ill. They didn't know what was wrong with him. They did everything, took him to the hospital. He would be watching the pornography and be committing masturbation. They took him to the hospital. The doctor did everything they could in this country and they couldn't. They took him back home. He was dying. The parents started praying. Every night they go into his room and start praying. And start praying. The young bobo that he was, he said he didn't know how to pray. But because the parents would be praying for himself, he started memorizing the prayer point. When they go to bed, he would start praying it. When they go, he said, I said, one day, a huge ugly man walked out of his body and tore him up and said, the pain was so much. He screamed. His parents ran out of the room. They ran and said, mommy, I've been delivered. He said, what happened? He told them, that the power is been committing the masturbation. A young man went to a pastor and said, Pastor, please, this thing you can say about masturbation, I'm addicted to pastor. How can you be addicted to masturbation? Holy brother, I kill. Don't fire him, brother. Pray your mom in the church. How can you be the guilty of masturbation? Don't you need to say that? Pastor, it's true. It's true, but I don't see anything wrong with it. Instead of committing fornication, let me just begin that. Pastor said, you can't hold. You can't speak it. I'm going to give you one prayer point. Trust deliverance ministers. I'm going to give you one prayer point. Just pray. 12 midnight. Pray until you get tired. You almost
sent him. Then you lie down and sleep. He started. Any power holding my life in bondage, release me. That life, release me. That life, release me. That life, release me. He prayed it. He prayed it for days. Nothing happened. He said, keep praying it. He prayed and prayed it again one night. A beautiful yellow city came to him. I said, why do you want to leave me now? I love you so much. He was looking at this woman. He woke up. He ran to the pastor. He said, hey, I saw a woman. Look at you. The pastor said, what did you do when you saw the woman? He said, I couldn't say anything. I was too short. Say, ah, you haven't started. You have to pray that prayer very well. He started praying it and prayed. The woman came this time with the baby. If you leave me, what will happen to our baby? Yeah, wow. He grabbed the baby. He smashed the baby to pieces. That was how the woman ran away. And that was the end of it. That's the power he has been committing the masturbation with. And there's no way he can find a wife to marry because his soul has been caged. That's the devil's plan. Because this is the end time. The devil knows his time is short. I said to women, don't tell me about sexual compatibility. Why you must have sexual relationship with a woman because with a man because you want to. No, what you're doing is you're fragmenting your soul. You're entering into evil covenants. Evil covenants cannot do you any good. Anybody that is in a cult, you sleep with the person, you have entered into the cult. And one of the things they tell people in the cult is sleep with virgins. When they sleep with the virgins, they know the virgins will sleep with other younger boys. That's how they pollute people. Amen? Praise the Lord. This is the end of my ministration, as I've been told my time is up. But the assignment I came for, I have to do it before I hand over the mic. Please, just give me 5 minutes. Amen? Praise the Lord. One of the things we talk about is abortion. Abortion is a blood sacrifice to the devil. Any Christian involved in abortion, you're not a Christian. You're involved in idolatry because the devil loves to drink blood. If I have the opportunity, I'll tell you the details why God hates abortion. God says the life of the flesh is in the blood. Once the blood is congealed, there's life there. You must not take it out. I'm going to make 2 points. One is the abstinence vow. If you are single, if you are a youth, even if you're married, I want you to make this vow. But if you're single, I want you to come out. Come out to the altar and make this vow. Please, let's do this candle. You want to make the vow of abstinence. You want the Holy Spirit to help you to present your body a living sacrifice unto God. You want to tell God from today, I will not have sexual relationship with anybody that I'm not legally married to. Let God help you. Please come out. I want to make that vow now. Please come out. Please come out. Goodbye, world. I'm staying no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures. I'll say, I'm ready for you. Please come on. Please come on. Please come on. Please come on. Come on. Come on.
God bless you. You'll be seated. Are you blessed?
Yes.
am blessed. Are you blessed?
Yes.
I am blessed. Are you blessed?
Yes.
Amen. Anytime you commit fornication or adultery, you lose your power. You lose your authority. I pray that our authority will not be taken away from us in the name of Jesus. And every power holding on is bonded for fornication and adultery shall be destroyed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's stretch forth our hands to our mommy and pray for her. Jesus, Father, we pray for her. Our mommy has to come to the field now. With the home and working in the name of Jesus. Let's come to bless us, Father, we ask to bless her. Bless our family, bless our ministry. In the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. I would like to call on our sister now for another praise session. Amen.
Amen.
I call on Sister Eunice.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus.
Let's
be on our feet as we worship the King of Kings, the authority of heaven and earth, the God who has made it possible for you and I to be in his presence this morning. Let's be on our feet as we are in the mode of worship. Amen. This is your presence.
Oh, Jesus.
This is your glory. This is your power. Let it be. This is your presence, Lord. This is your glory. This is your power. Let it be. The shadow of the this is your presence, Lord. This is your glory. This is your power. We say, let it rain. Let it rain.
Oh, your neighbor. Say, neighbor, are you ready to praise God this morning? Are you ready to shake your body this morning? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Joy overflows in my heart. Sing a new song to the Lord. Joy overflows. Joy overflows in my heart. Sing a new song. Sing a new song to the Lord.
Joy overflows.
Joy overflows in my heart.
Sing a new song.
Sing a new song to the Lord.
Oh, we will praise your name.
I will praise your name.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Let me go.
in the name of Jesus. So shall you be in Jesus' name. Amen. The flags are flying. Amen. Children, are you ready? Amen. I would like to call on our children to make that special number. Let's come for them as they come forward. Let's clap for them as they come forward. Clap for them, clap for them. Clap for Jesus in their lives. Clap for Jesus in their lives. Amen. Amen.
Because Thank you, choir. I'm so happy to see you again. Hallelujah.
If you know you are blessed to be here this morning, and you have not just come here to be a spectator, you have come to receive from the Most High, our Creator, our Father, the one who is able to do exceedingly abundantly of all that we can ever ask or imagine. I want you to jam your hands together for the King of Kings. Just like a holy dwelling. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we worship you. As we worship you, may your blessings come down. And I praise the ancestors of God, my Father. Father, let every flesh die. And you alone be saved. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Presence. Oh God, my Father, we're in the garment of presence. You are worthy, Lord. Let us not be pretenders in the house of God. Amen. God bless us in Jesus' name. Yeah. A round of applause for them. A round of applause for them. Amen. Amen. We're going to continue our service. And I'll have the pleasure to call on our brother, saxophonist, Brother Oluwa Tony. Amen. Amen.
Get my feet,
get my feet.
for the solid rock.
Solid rock.
For the solid rock.
For the solid rock.
I feel like shouting.
I feel like
shouting. Hallelujah. For the things we have to do.
For the things I've taken on.
My dream,
where can I go get to you?
My dream,
where can I go get to you?
My dream,
where can I go get to you?
My dream,
where can I go get to you?
Ibera, 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 Ibera,
Ibera, Ibera, Ibera,
Ibera, Ibera, Ibera, Ibera,
Ibera, Ibera, Ibera, Ibera,
Ibera,
Jesus' name.
Amen.
And Lord, let it be as a sweet smelling savour unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we are praising you, O Lord Almighty, we ask that you accept our praise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, everlasting Father, for Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. You can give your offering now.
Hallelujah! Amen. Hallelujah! Who will go crazy?
I'm gonna get it.
Disappointed if you are able to bless again. This is not the way we have.
I'm doing jobs and I'm giving you the song. I think messing you up or what? They let them get out. You want to sing the song very well? Am I correct? Am I right? I don't understand. We are praising Jesus in Igbo language, and this is not the way to do it. And my Igbo brothers are out. Are we ready? Are we ready? The time is gone. Okay, the time is to give them 2 more minutes. The time is gone. I want to hear the Igbo women sing and dance. It is not acceptable. They did not give us. Are we ready? Are the Igbo women ready? 2 more minutes, let's go now. Let me hear the Igbo women sing. Let me hear the Igbo women sing. Are we ready?
Oh,
out in the presence of God, please stand up and dance. Even if you don't know the meaning, but it's just present that you know that.
Oh,
and praising God when they are not here. Or they are not even strong enough to stand up. But I know that the Lord has given you the strength and you are praising, and the Lord will accept your praise in Jesus' name. I want you to help me join your stretch your right hand towards the choir and pray for all the members of the choir. Because this is a choir crusade, you want to open your mouth and begin to decree to their life that the Lord will touch their lives in Jesus' name. That the power of God will begin to baptize them in the name of Jesus. Just open your mouth and begin to speak to them. Open your mouth and begin to pray. All the blessings that you want for yourself, open your mouth and begin to release it into their lives. Release it unto them. That the choir will continue to flourish. That the choir will continue to multiply. That they will continue to grow from strength to strength. That they will continue to go from glory to glory. That the Lord will enlarge their hosts. The Lord will continue to give them the songs of praise. The Lord will continue to increase them on every side. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father, by the decree of heaven, I speak into the life of this, your children. They are the choir members of this church. We ask, O Lord, that every attack against them will not prosper in Jesus' name. I decree to their life that everything that has troubled them, but they still come to praise you, Lord. Father, I ask, O Lord, let their trouble disappear. Let their trouble disappear. Let their trouble disappear. Father, begin to give them their hands and give them a new song. A new song. A new song. Father, everything that is troubling them, and they have not been able to mention it, but only you know it, Father, I ask that you address their matter in the name of Jesus. And so I cover them and their families with the blood of Jesus. And I ask that you continue to do great and mighty things in their lives. Thank you for your love upon their life, for in Jesus' name we pray. And I decree that by this time next year, you shall be a bigger bundle of testimony in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. A loud hallelujah. Let's clap for the choir as they take their seat. Praise the name of the Lord. By the grace of God, we're going to continue the program by closing the program right now. Praise the name of the Lord. Go to the first set or the first section of the program before we now go out to have our community end of summer barbecue. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, the church will be open till anytime, till the whole of today. Praise the name of the Lord. So, we want to encourage every one of you to be part of the program outside in Jesus' name. We have invited the community, so please also join us and don't rush away. The Lord will bless you all in Jesus' name. And also, I want to use this opportunity to thank everybody that has participated in this program. Every one of you that has actually done one thing or the other, those of you that have contributed money, moral support, financially, and those of you that have prayed. I want to say the Lord God Almighty will reward you in Jesus' name. A louder amen to that. And I pray for all those that have been invited. I pray that the Lord God Almighty, who has lived to honor our invitation, will also honor you in Jesus' name. And I pray for all our children who are not here, who are also in their home room there, that the Lord will continue to strengthen them all in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. In love, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know we sang different songs from different places. I'm not sure we missed anybody out. Did you miss your tribe out and you had the song to sing?
Yes.
Oh, there's something like that?
Yes.
Oh, very good. So what we're going to do is that we're going to have a date for you next year in Jesus' name. And mean that the Lord will keep you alive then. Isn't it?
Yes.
You know, keep that because we must have met some people. Maybe you speak French, and we never sang in French. Or you speak Spanish, and we never sang in Spanish. Or German, and we never sang in it. But I pray that the Lord will keep it till the coming year in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So if Jesus palace and is coming, you and I will be alive in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
So if you have a song for us, when we're out there, you can actually sing it to us. Some of us will look and we'll watch you, we'll hear you. And the Lord will bless you all in Jesus' name. Let's have a prayer as we want to go to our closing prayers. To God be the glory, great things He has done. I pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, as we have come to praise you today, we ask, O Lord, that praises will never cease from our mouth in Jesus' name. As many that will be saying amen as I'm praying, I said, you will not know sorrow in the name of Jesus. I said, you will not know sorrow in the name of Jesus. All through your life and the days of your life, you shall be joy in Jesus' name. As you have sung and danced to the Lord today, I decree that the enemy will not know your address. Calamity will not know your address. They shall let you go. And I declare that every bondage in your life is broken forever. It's broken forever. It's broken forever. It's broken forever. I soak your life in the blood of Jesus. I soak your husband, your wife, your children in the blood of Jesus. Your properties will come out with the blood of Jesus. This week shall be a week of testimony. I can't hear you right now. You are happy. I command them to die by fire. Let your honor run on fire. Any power that wants to make you cry because they see you joyful, because they see you dancing, I command them to die by fire. In the name of Jesus, every arrow of darkness fired at you, I command the evil arrow to go back to fire. Let your honor run on fire. He will cover you with his hands. He will guide and protect you. Amen. And what of God says, I swung, let no man trouble me. For I bear my brother the marks of the Lord Jesus Christ. I decree that no power shall trouble you in Jesus' name. I say no power shall trouble you. Thank you, Father Lord. We speak to the remaining days of this month and this very week. We ask Almighty that it shall be a glorious week in Jesus' name. The Lord will strengthen you. He will uphold you. You will be at the right place at the right time. Thank you, Father, for your love. For in Jesus' name we pray. In loud amen. Let's share the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Be with us now and forevermore. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us. Raise your